Okay, so we're moving on to the third movement now. So, sliding the arm and the shoulder back, allowing the shoulder to dictate the movement, bringing the arm over, following the movement, and now rotating the arm backwards as you get to the extent of the movement. So the hand goes, the arm goes backwards, so your palm turns upwards. Yeah, hand goes backwards. That should feel like bringing your shoulder blade down. And then you're going to go diagonally across the body, rotating the arm the other way. So rounding the upper back, bringing the arm down across the body diagonally. So shoulders should stack one on top of the other. That's it. Bringing the, there we go, rounding the upper back. And then going diagonally back across and unwinding the arm. Yeah. Taking the arm back diagonally across, unwinding the arm. So rotating the arm. Palm goes upwards. Shoulder blade presses down. It opens up the chest. It arches the upper back. Coming back diagonally across the body. Rotating the arm around in the socket, rounding the upper back as the arm goes diagonally across. Yeah, taking the arm down more towards your knees because it's a diagonal movement, not a straight. There we go. Unwinding that movement, going back up towards the side, unwinding the arm. Yeah, unwinding the arm, shoulder blade comes down, palm goes upwards. Palm goes upwards, out towards the side. Yeah. And then unwinding that position, rotating the arm, bringing it diagonally. So you're going towards your knees, rotating the arm inwards, shoulder blade comes up, upper back rounds. And then once more, reversing the position, rotating the arm in the socket. Hand goes up towards the ceiling, shoulder blade comes down, arching the upper chest, opening the upper chest, arching the upper back, and then bring the arm over just normally until it touches the other hand. And just rest.